Making headlines tonight, Windy's nowhere near ready to defend T20 World Cup. Maradona's doctor investigated over manslaughter. And I and Mike forced to settle on a draw. Good evening and welcome to the Major ZDK Sports Edition for Monday, November 30, 2020. I'm your presenter, Terry Laraji. Now for the details. We begin tonight bowling off with cricket. Windies are nowhere near ready to defend their T20 World Cup next year. That is the thoughts of West Indies white ball captain Kyron Pollard after the side's humiliating defeat by New Zealand in the second T20 international on Saturday that led the Black Caps to a 2-0 series victory.
In all honesty, I'll say no. There's still certain aspects that we need to, work upon in our cricket. So again, it's good that we have in these sort of series, away from home, guys getting opportunities, to stake a claim, guys pulling out before and guys getting an opportunity to fill and see what they have to offer. So again, the only good thing about the World Cup is not, tomorrow. And hopefully, guys can understand the magnitude when we have performance like this and the effects that it have.
West Indies were outplayed by New Zealand and lost by 72 runs after Glenn Phillips struck a superb maiden century to pilot New Zealand to a massive total of 238. Asked to score at just under 12 runs per over to win, West Indies never got their momentum going and lost wickets at regular intervals. Five batsmen scored 20 or more, but none reached 30. Scores New Zealand 238 for 3, Phillips 108, Conway 65 not out, West Indies 166 for 9, Pollard 28, Paul 26 not out, Jameson 2 for 15. It was a real woeful performance, both in the field and with the ball by the West Indies, leading Pollard to suggest his side didn't do themselves any justice.
I think we didn't do ourselves any justice. Obviously, there's no comparison in what we did Friday and what we did today. The end result is that we lost a cricket game. So, again, it's a matter of, trying to pick yourself up.
Kyron Pollard. Rain played an early spoiler in the third and final T20 international between New Zealand and the West Indies at the Bay Oval today, saving the Windies from a clean sweep in the series. Only 2.2 overs were possible in the contest, with the Windies finishing on 25 for 1. The two teams will now travel to Hamilton for the first test match at Seddon Park starting on Thursday, Wednesday 6 p.m. Eastern Caribbean time. Meantime, Nicholas Puran, Rovman Powell and a number of others will get a brief chance to show their aptitude for cricket's longest format as they were expectedly named in a 14-man West Indies A squad to face New Zealand A this week. In recent months, there have been calls to consider the informed Puran in particular for the Test cricket format, with his advocates insisting the shotmaker has the ability to adapt. Chief of Selectors Roger Harper, as a result, extended the invitation to players on the current tour interested in playing a set of three-day games that will take place at roughly the same time as the team's test matches. In addition to the interested white ball specialists, the team will consist of six reserve test players. The full squad reads Fabian Allen, Nkuma Bonner, Joshua De Silva, Brandon King, Kyle Mayers, Preston McSween, Shane Mosley, Nicholas Puran, Rovman Powell, Raymond Reefer, Jaden Seals, Romario Shepherd, O'Shane Thomas and Hayden Walsh Jr. The West Indies A-team tour schedule is December 3-6 at the Bay Oval and December 11-14 at Saxton Oval, Nelson. The four-day first-class match against New Zealand A finished in a draw yesterday. In reply to West Indies' mammoth first innings of 571, the Black Caps ended the match in their first innings on 440 for 8. Scores New Zealand A 440 for 8 declared, Young 133, McConchy 124, Shamar Holder 3 for 100, Craig Brathwaite 2 for 66. West Indies 571, Craig Brathwaite 246, Darren Bravo 93, Blackwood 53. Meantime, Dawid Malan justified his standing as the top-ranked batsman in T20 international cricket with a match-winning half-century in the second match yesterday against South Africa to claim the series. Scores England 147 for 6 off 19.5 overs, Malan 55, Shamsi 3 for 19, beat South Africa 146 for 7, de Kock 30 by 4 wickets. England leads the three-match series 2-0. The third and final match bowls off on Tuesday. And Steve Smith scored a second straight 62-ball century, propelling Australia to a 51-run win in the second one-day international yesterday over India, clinching the series with a game to spare. Scores in that match, Australia 389 for 4, Smith 104, Warner 83, India 338 for 9, Kohli 89, Rahul 76. The final match bowls off on December 1. Meanwhile, local teams here in Antigua and Barbuda are gearing up for the ABCA 10 Splash Tournament, which commences at the end of the week. While speaking on ZDK Sportsline show, Pickett's head coach Ajani Fredericks explained how his side has been concentrating on the tactical aspect of the game.
For this tournament, being specific on this tournament, we are actually concentrating on this tournament, meaning we're doing specific towards this tournament. We're looking at who's going to be the finishing bowler, who's going to be batting the last five overs, who's going to start innings, who's going to bowl at which player. So it's more tactical than, it comes with a lot of skill, but it comes with a lot of tactical stuff. We can't approach every tournament is different.
Ajani Fredericks. The ABCA 10 Splash Tournament bowls off on Saturday at the Sir Vivian Richards Cricket Stadium. Meantime, Sydney Thunder claim their second Women's Big Bash League title after limiting Melbourne Stars to 86 for 9, the lowest score in a Women's Big Bash final at North Sydney Oval on Saturday night. The Thunder eased to their target with some 38 balls to spare to win by 7 wickets. In other sporting developments tonight, kicking into football, national hero of Antigua and Barbuda, Sir Viv Richards, has given his blessings for the staging of the Island Cup Open, a franchise football tournament set to start in the summer of 2021 in Antigua and Barbuda. The tournament will involve 9 other franchises across the region, Central and South America, including Brazil. Sir Viv said it is a great initiative for young players around the region.
Let me take this opportunity to say how delighted and excited I am to be part of the Island Cup as an ambassador. I'm really looking forward to it. I know it's a great initiative that will give our young footballers in the region an opportunity for them to highlight their product. So I'm really looking forward to it. Hopefully happen next year. We know that we are going through some trial times at this particular time with COVID-19.
Sir Vivian Richards. The private franchises are owned by investors branded under the respective countries, with the best available players to play their trade in one integrated arena, kicking off in August 2021. Sir Viv, who has played World Cup football for Antigua and Barbuda, has thrown his full support behind this project as brand ambassador, fully endorsing the initiative by the Caribbean Football Trust Limited. Meanwhile, in the English Premier League over the weekend, Newcastle defeated Crystal Palace 2-0. Riyad Mahrez scored his first Manchester City hat-trick as Pep Guardiola's side beat Burnley 5-0. Brighton scored a late penalty to hold Liverpool to a 1-1 draw. Leeds defeated Everton 1-0. West Brom beat Sheffield United also 1-0. Man United came back from 2 goals down to edge Southampton 3-2 thanks to a brace from Cavani. Tottenham stayed top of the Premier League despite being held by Chelsea in a highly competitive yet goalless London stalemate. An Arsenal boss, Mikel Arteta, said he is not worried about his position after his side slumped to their worst start to a season since 1981 with a 2-1 defeat at home by Wolves, their first win at Arsenal for 41 years. Today, Leicester missed the chance to join league leaders Spurs and Liverpool on top of the table after going down to Fulham 2-1. So after 10 matches, Tottenham are top on 21 points by goal difference over Liverpool. Chelsea are third on 19, Leicester sit fourth on 18 points, and Southampton are fifth on 17 points by goal difference over Wolves. Meantime, Argentine prosecutors are reportedly investigating Diego Maradona's doctor for possible manslaughter following the footballing legend's death 5 days ago. Police in Buenos Aires have searched the house and private clinic of Leopoldo Luque as they tried to establish if there was negligence in Maradona's treatment following surgery. The 60-year-old died of a heart attack at his home where he was recuperating. His daughters have pressed for details about their father's medication. Maradona had a successful operation on a brain blood clot earlier in November and had been due to be treated for alcohol dependency. Lionel Messi paid tribute to the late Maradona after scoring in Barcelona's 4-0 La Liga win over Osasuna on Sunday. Forward Messi unveiled a Newell's Old Boys shirt, one of Argentina great Maradona's former clubs, after his side's fourth goal. Touching down in Gridiron in week 12 of the NFL, the Titans comfortably beat the Colts 45-26 as Henry rushed for 178 yards and three touchdowns. The Falcons thrashed the Raiders 43-6. The Dolphins beat the Jets 20-3. The Patriots defeated the Cardinals 20-17. The Vikings just tipped off the Panthers 28-27. The Browns got over the Jaguars 27-25. The Giants defeated the Bengals 19-17. The Bills beat the Chargers 27-17. The 49ers beat the Rams 23-20. The Saints defeated the Broncos 31-3. In the battle of the quarterbacks between Brady and Mahomes, it was Mahomes' Chiefs who came out on top, beating the Buccaneers 27-24, and the Packers, they beat the Bears 41-25. Stepping in the boxing ring now, Iron Mike Tyson was denied a victorious return to the sport as his one-sided exhibition bout with Roy Jones Jr. was bizarrely scored a draw in LA on Saturday night. The 54-year-old Tyson was making a comeback 15 years after entering retirement for an exhibition bout with the 51-year-old Jones Jr., and the former world heavyweight champion exceeded expectations with a lively display that failed to receive recognition on two of the scorecards. Driving into motor racing, Lewis Hamilton took his 11th victory of the season in a Bahrain Grand Prix notable for a violent, fiery crash by Haas driver Romain Grosjean. Grosjean was taken to hospital with minor burns and suspected rib fractures after his car pierced the barriers on the first lap. The burning Haas was trapped sideways in the barrier, with nearly 30 seconds passing before Grosjean climbed clear as medical crews rushed to help. Hamilton was in control throughout to beat Red Bull's Max Verstappen. And finally tonight on this day in history, in 1928, debut of the Don. There was little hint of what was to follow as Don Bradman made only 18-1 in his first test appearance against England in Brisbane. Bradman was only 20. But fellow new boy Bert Ironmonger was 46, Australia's oldest test debutant at the time. It's not a match either man would have remembered too fondly. England won by a mighty 675 runs. Injuries to Jack Gregory, who didn't bat in either innings, and Charles Calloway, who didn't bat in the second, didn't help. But even allowing for that, Australia were hammered. They mustered just 122 and 66. And that story has brought us to the end of our sporting developments for tonight. Now to recap our top story. The Windies are nowhere near ready to defend their T20 World Cup next year. That is the thoughts of West Indies white ball captain Kieran Pollard after the side's humiliating defeat by New Zealand in a second T20 international on Saturday that led the Black Caps to a 2-0 series victory. I've been your presenter, Terry Laragi. Thank you for listening. To watch ZDK Sports Package, go to the YouTube channel of Terry Laragi, The Straight Bat, and subscribe. Stay tuned now for your Voice of America update to enjoy the rest of your evening. Rally, rally round the West Indies, one forever.